I'm gonna run over to Yasha and try to get my flask out of her. Okay. Try to swipe my flask back.
You're gonna try to swipe it. You're not even. You're gonna try to sneak it.
I'm gonna try to sneak it.
Okay.
All right. Go ahead and make a sleight of hand check.
Disadvantage.
Make a perception check.
Come on, Yash.
Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy.
Oh, disadvantage.
Oh, never mind.
I'm doing everyone but you right now.
What?
Did you roll?
Technically, it's a 23.
Yeah, with reliable talent.
I rolled a natural 20.
Oh! But what's the total on it?
What's the total? 23.
Oh, holy shit, you actually catch, not, you like after everyone's kind of taking a moment, and you're like, the blood's on you, and you kind of wipe it in a bit, and you walk over, and you take, just everyone's kind of like sitting down for a minute, and you feel this tug, and you glance behind you, and Nott is pulling the flask.
I'm just going to slap her without even looking. What are you doing?
28.
I can't shoot straight without my boobs! I wasn't shooting straight!
What are you talking about? You shot just fine.
No, I missed twice.
It's true, I saw shoot yourself in the eyeball.
I shot myself in the eyeball.
You gave me this flask. Do you really want me to keep it or do you want to take it?
I don't know anymore.
Don't take it, Nott.
I'll hold on to it for, how about I hold on to it until we get to Caduceus' destination?
All right.
Okay. Can I try to unrestrain myself, please?
Yes. After a moment, you manage to pull free of the hardened wax-like
of angry. On my turn, I wanted to shout out to Caleb. Caleb, Dwarven Forge is launching their Twitch channel on February 18th.
God damn it!
Check it out at twitch.tv/DwarvenForgeLive. Okay.
All right. Finishing Caleb's go. Jester, you're up. Caduceus, you're on deck.
All right. Nobody worry about me.
Okay.
Still standing, though very, very hurt.
Last chance. All right.
Finishes your go?
Yeah, I ain't going nowhere.
Top of the round, Beauregard, you're up.
Kaiju fight! Stop at that one!
No, you're small
now. Over there!
This one?
Small.
No, I'm small, because I'm big. Fight?
No.
Oh, yeah. As this is happening, Beauregard stomps over to that one. It just like becomes a normal Beauregard. And you go to stomp, and it's suddenly it's much larger than you remember.
My perspective changes.
Talking about dumb, idiotic people, I am talking about the most intelligent, ruthless people in this world.
I mean, Beau's right. I was a big fan of practical jokes, and I mean,
you were.
You were.
Things could get out of hand on occasion. It's been a while.
I knew I liked him.
I mean, if things do get out of hand, it can be a problem. Not going to speak more on the subject right now, but
well, you just don't know how to escape.
I know. You just have to bounce away.
It's only a problem if you remain to be there for range.
No. So you could be like that, you know, where people ask you things and you don't do anything, and they'll still think you're doing something.
But I've already been so involved. Won't they be disappointed if suddenly I'm just not appearing?
Well, we just have to establish it as like there's like a new way of doing things, you know.
Interesting.
Like, you've gotten so powerful that you're always with us, and you hear our thoughts, and you control everything, and...
So the party is a goodbye, kind of, loosely.
But not for me, just for all those other people that are, like, less important.
And now they have friends, they've met, they can...
They can rely on each other.
Right, I love that. Totally. When anything goes good, it's because of me. If anything goes bad, it's because of them.
Right, or, you know, they'll find greater purpose in the bad things. You know, they'll be like, oh, everything happens for a reason.
It's ridiculous, but I'm happy for them to be content with that.
I know. So
nothing happens for a reason. It's absolute fucking chaos.
This guy.
Love him.
Oh, no.